Retilin singkatnya sih salah satu project dari Gardo sendiri yang akhirnya dimulai dari 2011 sampai sekarang berkembang dalam segi konten, dalam segi orang yang datang, dalam segi teman-teman yang bantuin. Retilin sendiri basically jadi awalnya dari bazar pakaian sampai jadi festival graffiti skala internasional. Si Streetilin sendiri dari 2011 itu kita di kontrakan lama kita di Carburetor Spring. Kenapa di ngadainnya 1-8 di situ? Karena ada satu area di belakang yang bisa kita gunain terus selama acara. Jadi ya itu tadi balik ngebangun ekosistemnya sih. Makanya ketika pindah ke sini kita paham nih kita nggak punya tempat main yang sama kayak di 2011 sampai ya 2015. Akhirnya kita berusaha membangun jejaring, nyari tempat untuk venue. Akhirnya si kontennya berkembang jadi rangkaian acara. Dan
secara konten sih akhirnya berkembang ya, yang tadinya cuman berangkat dari bazar terus ada gambarnya. Kalau sekarang ketika kita melihat spot yang lebih besar lagi, berarti ada harus ada beberapa diisi oleh konten-konten baru lagi gitu. Pada saat itu sih kita mikirnya ya udahlah, nggak usah jauh-jauh dari kita, kayak bikin pameran contohnya. Terus kayak karena kita sekarang giving back the community, karena kita tinggal di lingkungan warga, bertetangga, bermasyarakat, jadi nggak ada salahnya juga kita bikin program yang benar-benar langsung mendekatkan diri ke masyarakat. Kayak Bayaran Camp Project itu kita gambar di kampung dengan orang-orang di tetangga-tetangga kita yang memfasilitasi tempatnya, dan kita yang meng-hire seniman-seniman untuk gambar di Street Dealing Festival. Ya mungkin kalau secara konten itu akhirnya ada penambahan street beat, hip hop gigs-nya, terus ada street playground yang mempertemukan across komunitas di luar graffiti, ada BMX, skateboard, b-boy dan lain-lain.
Nama Vivus, terus keterlibatan di Street Dealing yang sekarang sebagai keterlibatan di Street Dealing sekarang sebagai senimannya yang kurang lebih sekarang udah Asia ikutan kayak gini, sama sih kayak festival-festival graffiti gitu juga.
Yeah, I do graffiti since 25-26 years now, and I started like as a little boy with chalk in my room. I painted the walls of my room, and then I did letters, and then my sister she told me like, hey, you know what you're doing is like it's called graffiti. So yeah, since then I was really infected by this virus. I call the virus graffiti. So more or less 25 years I do it as a professional beside on my job, but I quit my job a couple of years ago, so I'm doing art for a living since 4 or 5 years now, and it works. So yeah, I always I think Or for me, it's quite difficult to call graffiti street art. Graffiti is not part of street art. Street art is when people are walking around doing stencil stuff and using a spray paint. But of course, they're using a spray paint, but we are not the same. Graffiti is lettering, legal and illegal, on walls or trains and doing tags and stuff. And to, yeah, take some space from the city to take it back. Okay, so street art is like kind of a movement which is like super hip and nice and everybody wants to be a street artist, so come on, fuck it. This is like everybody can cut a fucking stencil and to spray a stencil in like 2 seconds on a wall. I mean, it's okay when they do it, but it's not my thing. I don't want to do it with stencil and stuff like this. I want to do graffiti with guys from different countries, and I want to paint and show my name, and that's what's all about. That's graffiti lettering. Yeah.
My style, I always like draw a girl, and like it actually is like my passion is like the beauty, the woman bodies, or something like aesthetic of the woman, or flower that mix it and show it how is a woman beauty is.
I'm Frinky Fir from Singapore.
Ya, saya Nekati dari Indonesia sebenarnya, cuma saya udah lama tinggal di Singapura.
So I think we go to few places, Malaysia, Hong Kong. So I think we want to meet new people. And then this festival we always see from 2016, 2017. So we want to go 2018, but it's not there. So 2019, because we met Close at Meeting of Styles Malaysia, and then he want us to come to this festival. So we got invited lah to join. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, our art is always collaboration. So they are on that side lah, it's always a female character. For me, it's robot, monster, animal. Yeah, so collaborate-nya Beauty and the Beast gitulah konsepnya selalu. Yeah.
Or big or small kind lah. Yeah. Dia selalu bikin sesuatu yang besar gitu, dan selalu bikin sesuatu yang lebih kecil.
Yeah. Difficult question lah. Okay, Singapore, I think many people know is like very clean, very strict city. Yeah, so. Very different from Jakarta, but there is a community. So for us, like we are around the graffiti shop. We have a few graffiti shop, Black Hook, Utama. We try to promote this community and still keep the subculture alive. So now, I think because we do it in a more legal way lah. Still there is kids who will come and want to learn how to do legal way. So we teach them how to do legal, how to get permit, how to where you can paint. So we kind of try to promote lah this culture still. Yeah, but it's hard because people think graffiti is bad in Singapore. Yeah, so it's tough to keep it alive.
Ya, untuk di Jakarta gitu ya, di Indonesia kan kayaknya lebih lively ya, kayak scene-nya gitu. So, kita juga pengen berusaha kayak bawa itu juga lah ke Singapura gitu. Yeah, we try to be kayak sering painting juga gitu. To make it like, to keep up lah sama negara-negara sebelah lah, kayak Indonesia, Thailand gitu, Vietnam.
We still have festivals, small-small festival, maybe like Aliwal, Streets. Aliwal Street Festival gitu, jadi ada skateboarding, ada hip hop, ada mural graffiti. I think few years ago ada Do You Love Me, ada painting di sana. Jadi harus berjuang lah untuk culture-nya keep going lah.